Hi, good evening. It's 6 o'clock and I'm here for the business buzz. Yes, the busy could be and the business buzz. You know, let's get buzzing and let's get you buzzing because tonight it's all about networking and all about how can you network more efficiently? How can you grow your tribe? Because networking, it is the best way to actually market yourself. It's the best way. You love your business, you know your business. You're the best person to market your business. So go out and share the love with everybody. And you know, I know you're gonna say, oh, it's easy for you, Claire. Hi, Britt. Nice to see you here. Hi. Hi, Danny. Nice to have you here. So, yeah, I mean, you know, you'll say, well, Claire, it's easy for you because, you know, you do that so simply. You know, it's just very easy for you. But it hasn't been easy for me, you know, and it's taken a long time and a lot of practice and a lot of learning to actually become more confident. Woo, hi, Jenny. So I just now, because, you know, I know those tips and tricks, I like to share them. And I'm just, you know, I think it's really important when I first went to a networking event that was 9 years ago, and it was at the Institute of Directors, so quite a, you know, quite a good big event, lots of, you know, CEOs of companies and managing directors, and me, little French girl, just arriving with my little, you know, handbag, and I was just arriving in this place, and I'm just thinking, oh, I don't know anybody. What am I gonna do? Or how am I gonna feel? So I went to the toilet and I did a bit of pep talk. I put a bit of lipstick on. I just put my shoulders out and I walked in that room, and I've just pretending I was so confident. I was pretending. It is a lot of pretend, and pretending is also fabulous because you've got to remember one thing. The way you think will affect the way you feel, which will affect the way you behave, right? So let me say that again. If you think, oh, I hate networking, I'm never gonna, I don't know anybody, I don't want to go, I don't know what to talk about. Well, your body's gonna go, oh, it's gonna go like that. Your head's gonna go down. You're gonna feel completely, you know, down, and your level of energy will go down, and you'll never want to go. Then you'll just decide or find an excuse and you won't go, or you'll stay in a corner somewhere, hoping that no one's gonna come and talk to you and not do anything about it. So think positive. Think, what is it that you want to achieve? Prepare yourself. So we talked about preparing ourselves. Last couple of weeks, you know, what is your story? Why do you do what you do? How do you do it? What do you do? You know, have all that already, and you know, we talked about it. And this is when all that start, you know, we talked about previously, is coming into practice, so you can then, you know, very confidently talk about your business and why you're here and what's your passion. So learning your story is really, really important. So inside in your head, you're thinking very positive. You will feel very positive because you know what you're talking about, and then you'll behave positively. So you'll have your shoulders out, you'll have a nice smile, you'll make eye contact, a nice handshake, that is always really good, and a nice smile. And just think about it. You know, a smile doesn't cost anything, right? And it has to be the most incredible gift you can give somebody, is give them a smile. And if they're a bit shy and you're a bit shy and smiling to each other, well, it's gonna work, isn't it? You know, you can only just, you know, smile at each other and start up a conversation. So be prepared. Top one, you know, just double check the emails. Where is it that you're going? What's the locations? Where are you gonna have to park? What time is it? Double check the things. There's nothing worse than going a place thinking, oh, I'm going to this hotel, and actually the event in the other hotel. So you'll have to transfer, move the car, you'll be all flustered, your hair will be like that, you know, and it's not a good thing. So be prepared. Also, check out the list. Do you have the list? Who's coming? Can you see? Can you ask the organizer? Can you actually get those details so you are prepared? You're already seeing who's coming, and you may as well already, you know, looked and check out a few people online, which is great because with LinkedIn now, this is what you do. Really, really good, and really good to be prepared so you can start conversation with others. Tip two, dress to impress. Yes, learn, check, you know, what is the dress code? And, you know, you don't want to be dressed up like a, you know, like a I was going to say a penguin. It's not very nice to be a penguin, but you don't want to arrive in the place and everybody's wearing black suit and then you're the only one wearing jeans. That's just not going to happen, right? Okay, so just check where you're going, what's the dress code is. So you feel comfortable, you know, if it's smart, casual, you know, make sure you check this out beforehand. Tip three, okay? Never, ever, 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 yes, Sandrine, I'm talking to you. Thanks for coming, but yes, I'm talking to you. Never, ever, ever go out ever again without your business cards. Your business cards should be absolutely everywhere. In your handbag, in your wallet, in your car. A business cards absolutely everywhere. Even, you know, I was saying that, I did a workshop a few months ago, probably about a year ago, and I said that to, you know, the one of my tips, you know, never go out without it. Even when you drop off the kids at school, never go out. And then the next day, I had the lady who emailed me and she said, you won't believe it, Claire. I had my business card in my handbag at dropping off the kids, and I managed to give two of them. And I was like, yeah, this is amazing. So, yes, fabulous. Business card, never go out without them because you never know when you need them. Okay? Pep talk. Okay, a little thing as well. You know, we know you can, you know, arrive and, you know, go to the toilet, get a bit of time, you know, make sure you're prepared, check out, you know, if you need a bit of lipstick, do you need to check that you've got your hair done, you know, you've got none of this on your teeth, that kind of things, right? And then when you're in the toilet, give yourself a bit of a pep talk. So remember, how you think is going to affect how you feel, it's going to affect how you behave. So if you think, oh yes, this is going to be really good, I'm going to make lots of new connections, I'm going to, you know, I'm going to grow my, I'm going to give lots of business cards, fantastic. Think about it, give yourself that, yes, I can do it. Right, okay. A little trick, tips and trick now for nerves. And, you know, I know we're like that and hands are sweating and you're just like on your trousers trying to do that. Because you're thinking, oh, I'm going to be shaking hands and then my hands are sweating because I'm so nervous. Okay, so there's a couple of things that you could be doing. Before going, you could do a bit of grounding. So just, you know, take 10 minutes or 5 minutes before you go and just, you know, ground yourself to the floor and just make sure that you kind of breathe in and out deeply and just get yourself really back into your right place so you're feeling that your head is empty and then you can just go back into the place as well. A little trick for your, if you are in the place, is actually in your shoes, wiggle your toes. Okay, so if you're in somewhere and you're finding yourself, you're starting wandering and starting getting a bit stressed out, wiggle your toes. Because once you wiggle your toes, your brain's going to be thinking, I'm wiggling my toes, and you'll stop thinking about everything else. So that's a really good tip. Always wiggle your little toes. And give it a bit of a squash, you know, a little bit of a squish. If you got some of those little balls or something like that, you can do a little bit of a squish things as well for little nerves tips. It's really good. And another one is you can tap here on the side of your hip, right? There's a little, hi, Stefan, nice to be here. Lovely to join us. Hi, Claire, lovely to be here. On the side here, tap a bit on the side of the hip here and I'll get the... There's like a little nerves here and then you touch that bit and then it'll just give you a bit more of a boost and, you know, calm your nerves down. My other little tip is your body language. Okay, so it says that 55% of people make a first impression of yourself, of you, by just looking at you. So they don't talk to you, they don't know who you are, they will make a first impression of you within... That's 55% will make that first impression by just looking at you. So that body language needs to bring, you know, needs to be powerful. You want to be here. You want to show. You want to, you know, you want to, you know, be prepared. You want to be in advance. You want to come and just really kind of have that handshake with their hand, the palm open. So it's opening. You know, I do a lot of kissing, so I'll go and kiss everybody. And sometimes, whoa, the French, they're okay. They don't mind kissing, but the English sometimes will be like, whoa, what does she want to me for? So, you know, knowing what you're doing. But the body language is really important because you can read if somebody's lying on the side, you know, like that, you'll know that they won't be bothered. And it's the same with you, you know, different tips and tricks. And actually, if you want to know some more about body language and all that kind of things, Jenny and Britt and myself, we're going to be running a workshop at the end of March, but I'll tell you more about that, you know, because it's a bit of a all excitement. We're pulling all together, but there's been loads to learn there. So quickly, watch your body language, have your shoulders out, you know, make sure that your head's up, your eyes are wide open, your smile is there, your handshake is, you know, and networking, it's about listening to people, okay? And that's really important. Be present, right? Be present to listen to somebody. Don't be here and try to answer them. You know, it needs to be a two ways, but you've got two ears and one mouth, and use it appropriately. So use it that you're listening to what they've got to say. Listen and listen, and they will think that you're the best person that they've talked about to tonight because you've listened. And remember, people like to think that they're important, and what they and who they are, what they think is important. So let them talk, you know, let them talk. And then it's all about being part of the service. You know, you want to listen to what they've got to say, so then you can see how you can help them with that. So that's it for tonight because I've got loads more I could tell you about networking, but we'll do a little bit more on feet, on where to start in the networking event. We'll do that another time because we can't just be doing a 3 hours workshop live now on Facebook. You know, we'll have to do something else. Hi, Rachel, nice to see you here. Just to say, if you are in Jersey and you want to do some networking, I'm here tomorrow. We're at the Grand tomorrow night, 6:30. You can book online, busyqueenbee.com/events, and it's speed buzzing. It's just amazing. You would love it. You've got 2 minutes to introduce yourself, and then you'll be able to move around and speak to all the people in the room in 60 minutes. It is super amazing. And I just love speed buzzing so much that I wanted to do something new and exciting. So, are you ready? Yes, we're gonna be doing speed buzzing online on Instagram on Thursday night. Yay! Live on Instagram, speed buzzing. So if you fancy it, if you want to come and share the screen with me and talk to people about what's your, you know, what is your passion, what is your story, what do you do and why do you do it, you'll have 2 minutes, 6 o'clock Instagram. I'd love to see you there. Right, everybody, thank you, Brits, thank you, everybody. It was really lovely to see you. I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.